We have been conduct in collaboration with the Australia Sydney University for implement the Professor Guy Mark for implement the research ACT3 in Kamau. For the research is so that if we screen everyone with the expert for all the adults in the community, this is we conducting in 4 years. So for the 60 subcommunities with the intervention and 60 subcommunities with the control, we screen about the nearly the 60,000 population. After 3 years of the intervention, is screening for the screening for everyone with the expert and to finding the TB cases, even if they without the symptom. And after 3 years, the incident is compared to the between the intervention arm and the control arm is a reduction is around this is the compared to the previous 4 years is a reduction is about 68%, and compared with the control arm, this is also is showing the big reduction is a I not remember exactly, but in the paper, but this is more than 30%. I am proud to say that Vietnam is one of the 7 countries have been selected to participate in the phase 3 of MR72 vaccine clinical trial. If the trial shows that we can come close to the 50% vaccine efficacy measure on phase 2, it will be a big step toward ending TB. And we expect to launch the trial next year. And based on 5-year follow-up, we would be able to have an answer ending TB by 2030. Of course, having a safe and effective vaccine cover only the clinical aspect and finding a way that 96 million relatively healthy people are rich and agree to take the vaccine is another challenge that you have may have seen in many countries developing or industrially perform at different level of success. This is the another positive sign for Vietnam, as we have convincing demonstrated from September to December of the 2021 during the COVID-19. During the month that precedes the lifting of all lockdown measures, we vaccinate hundreds of thousands of people per day. During our goal speed vaccination campaign in some of the epicenter of the pandemic. For example, in Hanoi, our capital, from 12 to 14 September, we vaccinated for more than 1.6 million people, almost 2% of our population. In the 3 days, with a peak of the more than 500,000 people in 1 day. And so that we believe that if the vaccine proves to safe and effective, we will advocate with the Ministry of Health and the key stakeholder of the government, as well as the multilateral and bilateral partner to help us to procure and administer their vaccine as fast as possible to hopefully reach the sufficient immunity to rapidly reduce the TB, activate TB cases, and disrupt the community transmission. I would like to clarify that this is in Vietnam. Even this is the we try to implement the expert as the initial test for diagnosed TB, but this is not covered for all the TB at the diagnostic time. Let's say, for example, in 1 year, we in Vietnam we detected and notified 100,000 TB cases. So in order to finding the 100,000 TB cases, it's around 80,000. This is the pulmonary TB cases. We need about 700,000 testing for the presumptive TB in order to find 80,000 of the pulmonary TB cases or 100,000 of TB cases. So, however, in 1 year, even if the expert test has been increased year by year in Vietnam from the year 2011 until the year 2022. But in last year, we have using around 350,000 expert tests in the whole country. We cover expert tests for all the TB cases that have been detected for finding of the MDR TB cases, the multi-drug resistant and rifampicin resistant TB cases. And we have been covered for about 26 to 30% of the presumptive TB case is have been using the expert at the time of diagnosis. So the situation is merely quite similar to the India. However, it is the India is the number of the TB case is much more bigger because you are in the very big country and big population, and the number of the presumptive TB is much bigger. So in Vietnam, we also implementing the CHUNA, but only in the districts with the distance and in the remote area. This is with the support from the STOP-T partnership through the new tool project and US AID. We have in Vietnam, we have implementing the CHUNA for detecting the MDR TB cases and also for TB cases. And we got the 30S machine. And for the CHUNAT, we focus to implement in the remote area and in the districts with the far distance to the provinces. So, and also in the deep country districts, which have some problem with the example for the condition to implement the expert machine. So our plan, our RTB plan is also would like to extend the both expert and CHUNA and TB LAM in the next period of 3 years in order to increase the molecular test for testing for the presumptive TB cases. This is currently in Vietnam. Vietnam is only covered for 30% of the presumptive TB cases. This is one thing. This is we would like to using the expert as the initial test is for testing the OTB all presumptive TB cases. However, it's something different for Vietnam. Main thing is the resources. This is up to now the expert test is and the expert machine is only. Well, we have only the one resources from the donor from the Global Fund projects. And in the whole Vietnam, we have about 320 the expert machine. And we have more than 700 districts. So some districts is the all the 63 provinces in Vietnam have expert machine, but the expert size is only 183 expert size. So many of the districts have a no expert machine. So we have to base on the sputum transportation for sample transportation for the expert test for the districts have a no expert machine. And because of the sputum transportation is not good enough, so many of K is not yet reached the expert at the time of the diagnosis and still use the microscopy. And we are also in the planning is to increase the coverage of the expert and expert test for all the presumptive TB in Vietnam. So we have a solution. The first one, moving not only based on the global fund project for the expert test and expert machine, but also we importation the expert test. We have the company to importation the expert test and expert machine to Vietnam, to the country, and selling it. So for the private sector and for the government, we can use expert test and reimbursement using the health insurance. So we will use the resort of the health insurance is the for cover of the expert test previously and currently is mainly the testing. This is procured through the Global Fund project.
Welcome to another episode of NTB Dialogues 9490 Global Voices series. We began this series at the midpoint when, since the time when the governments had committed to NTB and deliver on other SDGs in 2015. Over 90 months have passed by now since then, and about less than 90 months are left to meet those targets. Today, we have a very special guest amongst us. He is no other than Dr. Nguyen Binh Hoa. He's the Vice Director of Vietnam National Lung Hospital, Vice Manager of Vietnam's National TB Program, Director of Vietnam Integrated Center for TB and Respiratory Research, which is also known as VICTRI, and Vice Director of Vietnam Global Fund TB Project in Vietnam. He has a very long and distinguished service when it comes to lung health, lung research, as well as work on the ground in helping Vietnam shape the TB response as well as address TB. So welcome, Dr. Hoa. Thank you so much. I know it's very late in the night, but you found time for us. Very grateful. Welcome.
Yeah, thank you very much. You're welcome.
Thank you, Hoa, Dr. Hoa. So, Dr. Hoa, one of the important things which comes to my mind, first of all, is in the last 90 months in Vietnam, please tell us what has happened in the fight against TB. But before you do that, also tell us more about the research which has come from Vietnam, the evidence that we can actually end TB if we screen everyone in the community, not just those who have symptoms. This people like Dr. Guy Marx and others have advocated, have shared that in Australia, rich nations, 40, 50 years ago, this was done. They screened everyone for TB. They did not have the modern tools for diagnostics or new medicines and treatment regimens, but they screened everyone for TB and brought down the TB rate. I read that important research, so just wanted to flag that, and over to you to hear what has happened in terms of fighting TB in Vietnam under your leadership. Thank you, Dr. Hoa.
Yeah, thank you very much. Regarding to for the research for the purpose of the ending TB in Vietnam, this is in the year 2015, we have been conducting in collaboration with the Australia Sydney University for implement the Professor Guy Mark for implement the research ACT3 in Cà Mau. For the research is so that if we screen everyone with the expert for all the adults in the community. This is we conducting in 4 years. So for the 60 commune, 60 sub-commune with the intervention and 60 sub-commune with the control, we screen about the nearly the 60,000 population. After 3 years of the intervention, we screening for the screening for everyone with the expert and to finding the TB cases, even if they without the symptom. And after 3 years, the incident is compared to the between the intervention arm and the control arm is a reduction is around this is the compared to the previous 4 years is a reduction is about 68%, and compared with the control arm, this is also is showing the big reduction is I not remember exactly, but in the paper, but this is more than 30%. So based on that, this is for the one of the basic thing is we conduct for the double X strategy in Vietnam. This is we implement strategy is the expert X-ray for screening and for finding the people with the TB suggestion in the X-ray, and we conduct the expert test for the who is have a TB is abnormal in the chest X-ray, because we have not enough the resources to screen everyone with the expert. Even this is the so it's a very big impact, but it's very costly. So for implementation, we use a strategy is a double X to X-ray for screen, and then it's an expert for diagnosis, and apply for the people with have a high who have a high risk of the getting TB. Example for the old people or the people is living in the same household or household contact with the TB patient, or people with the symptom, or people is with the other high risk disease. Example is HIV or diabetes. So we invite them to the even is without the symptom to the chest X-ray, and after the chest X-ray, who have a chest X-ray abnormal, we can do the expert for finding TB.
Yeah, thank you so much for sharing that. That is very important evidence from Vietnam, which has come 68% reduction in new TB cases, if I understood you correctly. This is huge.
Yes.
And sir, this is like, you know, this shows the path to end TB. So first of all, we need to find the missing cases. And this is a gold standard way which you did, because even WHO recommendations say that the first test should be molecular test. And you use the molecular test and you screen them using X-ray. This is amazing, especially the kind of impact which you have shown. So thanks a lot, Dr. Hua, for sharing that. And let us hope that it inspires more action from other governments and countries on the ground. So, Dr. Hu, where is Vietnam in terms of ending TB? In terms of, are we on track in terms of new cases? What about treatment regimens which have been rolled out in Vietnam in the last 90 months? Can you just give us an overview or sense of where are we right now? And in the next question, we can listen to you. What more is it offering in the next 90 months when Vietnam goes TB free? Let's hope that it happens soon.
Thank you. This is Vietnam is on track to the NTB. This is quite difficult to say whether we are on track to NTB and not as there are pros and cons. In terms of the cons, even it's before the COVID-19, progress is too slow to NTB by the year 2030. Before the COVID-19 pandemic, we estimate that TB prevalence and mortality among adults in Vietnam had been declining by 4% each year. The incident in Vietnam is were estimated to decrease by 3% per year. And Jared, we would need until 2080 to end TB in Vietnam. It's to reduce the TB incident is less than 10 per 100,000 population. The pandemic COVID-19 has made the task of the ending TB is even more challenging. In the year 2021, the year when COVID-19 had the biggest impact on the TB services in Vietnam, we have the number of the notified TB patients that declined is about 24% lower compared to the 2020 and 2019. This is the we detected and notified only 78,000 cases, TB cases in Vietnam, compared to the 103,000 TB cases detected and notified in the year 2019. It also represents a decline in the treatment coverage to under 50%. This is, if I remember exactly, it's around 46%. This does not even account for the long-term effect on the healthcare and the TB care system. It will be likely take years to reverse the negative effect of the pandemic on human resources for health in Vietnam. And despite the severity of the drop in the case notification due to COVID-19, it only lasts 1 year. And when Vietnam achieved the sustained control of the COVID-19 epidemic, and movement restrictions have been removed, the health system resumed functionality relatively quickly. Health seeking behavior within the general population similarly returned to normal as well. This enables us to return our attention to providing high quality of TB care and prevention service, and restarting the implementation of the national strategic plan to end TB by the year 2030, as mandated by the Prime Minister, decision number 374, approving the national strategy for TB. By prioritizing TB screening and prevention at all levels of the health system, from the national to the province and district and community level, we achieved an almost instant recovery. The number of TB notification rose to 103,000 cases have been detected and notified again in the year 2022. This number were at the same level of notification as before the COVID-19 pandemic, but it took us more than 2 years of time. One may argue that the key turning point in COVID-19 pandemic was mass vaccination. And as you may recall, having a safe and effective vaccine for TB also this is a very important factor of the end-TB strategy. Specifically, it assumes that accelerates decline in incident from 2025 to 2030 at the necessary rate of 25% or higher is only possible with a new vaccine. On that end, I am proud to say that Vietnam is the one of the seven countries have been selected to participate in the phase 3 of MR72 vaccine clinical trial. If the trial shows that we can come close to the 50% vaccine efficacy measure on phase 2, it will be a big step toward ending TB. And we expect to launch the trial next year. And based on 5-year follow-up, we would be able to have an answer ending TB by 2030. Of course, having a safe and effective vaccine covers only the clinical aspect. And finding a way that 96 million relatively healthy people are rich and agree to take the vaccine is another challenge that you have may have seen in many countries, developing or industrially, perform at different level of success. This is another positive sign for Vietnam, as we have convincingly demonstrated from September to December of 2021 during the COVID-19. During the month that precedes the lifting of all lockdown measures, we vaccinate hundreds of thousands people per day during our goal speed vaccination campaign in some of the epicenter of the pandemic. For example, in Hanoi, our capital, from 12 to 14 September, we vaccinated for more than 1.6 million people, almost 2% of our population, in the 3 days, with a peak of the more than 500,000 people in 1 day. And so that we believe that if the vaccine proves to safe and effective, we will advocate with the Ministry of Health and the key stakeholder of the government, as well as the multilateral and bilateral partner, to help us to procure and administer their vaccine as fast as possible to hopefully reach the sufficient immunity to rapidly reduce the TB, activate TB cases, and disrupt the community transmission. So in summary, if you ask me if the Vietnam is on track, on again, it's indeed a difficult question. However, based on the condition provided and my conviction as the NTP deputy manager, I have to say that I believe we are still on the track to NTP, but only a few years less. However, given that target and timeline will be likely be revised from the 2030 to 2035 in Vietnam due to the COVID-19 pandemic, I actually believe that Vietnam is on track to NTP by the year 2035.
Thank you so much, Dr. Hua, for sharing this. This is such an important overview. And I congratulate Vietnam for being one of the countries which may, let us hope, that comes up with safe and effective TB vaccine in future, which will be a really such an important game changer when it comes to moving towards ending TB. So I just wanted to understand to what extent has Vietnam scaled up the use of molecular test, as WHO recommends it should be the first test for people with presumptive TB overall nationally. And sputum microscopy is on its way out for TB presumptive cases at least. Thanks.
I would like to clarify that this is in Vietnam. Even this is the we try to implement the expert as the initial test for diagnosed TB, but it is not covered for all the TB at the diagnostic time. Let's say, for example, in 1 year, we in Vietnam, we detected and notified 100,000 TB cases. So in order to finding the 100,000 TB cases, it's around 80,000. This is the pulmonary TB cases. We need about 700,000 testing for the presumptive TB in order to find 80,000 of the pulmonary TB cases or 100,000 of TB cases. So, however, in 1 year, even if the expert test has been increased year by year in Vietnam from the year 2011 until the year 2022. But in last year, we have using around 350,000 expert test in the whole country. We cover expert test for all the TB cases that have been detected for finding of the MDR TB cases, the multi-drug resistant and rifampicin resistant TB cases. And we have been covered for about 26 to 30% of the presumptive TB case is have been using the expert at the time of diagnosis. So the situation is merely quite similar to the India. However, it is the India is the number of the TB case is much more bigger because you are in the very big country and big population, and the number of the presumptive TB is much bigger. This is one thing. This is we would like to using the expert as a initial step is for testing the OTB or presumptive TB cases. However, it's something different for Vietnam. Main thing is the resources. This is up to now the expert test is and the expert machine is only we have only the one resources from the donor from the Global Fund projects, and in the whole Vietnam we have about 320 the expert machine. And we have more than 700 districts. So some districts is all the 63 provinces in Vietnam have expert machine, but the expert size is only 183 expert size. So many of the districts have no expert machine. So we have to base on the sputum transportation for sample transportation for the expert test for the districts have no expert machine. And because of the sputum transportation is not good enough, so many of K is not yet reached the expert at the time of the diagnosis and still use the microscopy. And we are also in the planning is to increase the coverage of the expert and expert test for all the presumptive TB in Vietnam. So we have a solution. The first one moving not only based on the Global Fund project for the expert test and expert machine, but also we importation the expert test. We have the company to importation the expert test and expert machine to Vietnam, to the country, and selling it. So for the private sector and for the government, we can use expert test and reimbursement using the health insurance. So we will use the resource of the health insurance is for cover of the expert test previously and currently is mainly the testing This is procured through the glofan protein. Regarding for the other molecular test in Vietnam, you mentioned to the TrueNAP. So in Vietnam, we also implementing the TrueNAP, but only in the districts with the distance and in the remote area. This is with the support from the STOP-T partnership through the new new tool project and US AID. We have in Vietnam, we have implementing the TrueNAP for detecting the MDR TB cases and also for TB cases. And we got the 30S machine. And for the TrueNAP, we focus to implement in the remote area and in the districts with the far distance to the provinces. So, and also in the deep country districts, which is have some problem with the example for the condition to implement the expert machine. So our plan, our RTB plan is also would like to extend the both expert and TrueNAP and TB-LAM in the next period of 3 years in order to increase the molecular test for testing for the presumptive TB cases. This is currently in Vietnam. Vietnam is only covered for 30% of the presumptive TB cases.
And thanks a lot for making big progress on transforming laboratory capacity of the whole nation. So all the best, Dr. Hua, for expanding, and using deploying the evidence and science so innovatively, so that we can reach as many people as possible. Let us hope this 30 becomes 100% as soon as possible. And it's so critical. And the scientific evidence which you have produced also guides, translates into national evidence of reducing the incidence, of course. So, Dr. Hua, you have already indicated us towards what more can be done in the next 90 months. But if there is anything else which you would like to add in terms of new diagnostics, in terms of deploying new treatments, let us pray that new vaccine comes from countries, one of which is Vietnam, where the clinical trial or research is currently underway, and we have a better vaccine for preventing TB. So what about the next 90 months? And before you do that, just let us know the regimens which are currently being used for a latent TB, drug-sensitive TB, and drug-resistant TB. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much. So I think this is, for example, is the testing is for in order to ending TB, we need this is apply the new tool, the new diagnosis test in order to close closing the health system to the community, this is also another thing is important. This is for the treatment of finding and treatment of TB infection cases. After the last UN high level meeting in the year 2018, Vietnam has committed to treating of the more than 300,000 individuals with the TB infection. And we have achieved only a fraction of that number in due to many reasons, starting with the pandemic COVID-19, but also including concern over our tuberculin quality treatment consistency among both healthcare provider and person with TB infection, TB care system capacity, and so on. While our drug-resistant TB management has been strong technically, our enrollment has consistently lags behind of the, our ambitious due to the limited resource for scaling up coverage of the first and second line drug susceptibility testing. Rapidly changing the guidance over the past several years, that take a lot of time and effort to operational, both from the policy perspective and in terms of the clinical practice from additional challenge. In terms of social protection, our national patient cost survey shows that 63% of the TB family affected by TB sensitivity cases, 60% is the catastrophic cost, and 98% of the drug resistant TB experience catastrophic cost. And we have established a fund to support poor family with TB, but this fund is entirely dependent on the charity donation, and therefore do not yet have sufficient resources to help all the winners. With that said, we are working hard to expand capacity in all the three areas with the support from partners such as the Global Fund and the USAID. And finding all the unreached person with TB is one of the main arm in our national strategic plan and represent a key highlight. The WHO estimates that we still do not reach about 40% of the 170,000 person with the incident TB. And the treatment coverage gap of around 70,000 people is estimated to split roughly into two parts. One half consists person with a new TB who are either asymptomatic or not health seeking, and whom we call underdiagnosis. We have a target group with the intensified active case finding in approximately 40 of 63 province, and now extend to the whole country. The other half is reaching healthcare facility, but not diagnosed or diagnosed and receiving treatment, but not notified. This form the underreported group whom we are targeting with the enhanced PPM, public-private mixed activity. And with respect to active case finding, we are employed two approaches. The first is the sustaining intensified systematic screening effort of the key vulnerable population, such as the contact people living with HIV and prisoner. Secondly, we have expanded the community-based active case finding using the mobile chest X-ray technology to indicate the first-line diagnostic testing using expert. And for that, we have a procure 27 mobile X-ray van and have a significantly scale up expert testing over the last several years that I already mentioned. And with this equipment, we have a screen 100,000 a person among household contact in prison, in HIV outpatient clinic, and among key vulnerable group in the community, such as the elderly and the urban poor, to find the TB among those under diagnosis. And with respect to the underreported person with TB, we receive a significant support from the Global Fund, Stop the Partnership, and USCDC to scale up a new PPM model in the last 3 years. This model is a local adaptation of the private provider interface agency model originally developed in India. Here in Vietnam, we have an in-gate, a local NGO called Friend for International TB Relief Office to serve as an intermediary agency and facilitate engagement and collaboration between us and all the healthcare providers outside of the NTB network, including the targeted application of primary care integration strategy, such as we call the PAN, is a practical approach to lung health. Together, we have signed the collaboration agreement with around 3,000 healthcare providers, ranging from small pharmacy to the national hospital. The model is one of the key factors in our recovery of the TBK finding in the year 2022 after the COVID-19. And we recorded at the rate of the 25% in contribution to the national case notification from the outside of the NTP network. This will more than double the rate of the contribution prior to implementation of the model. So I think this is for some of the other to decide the new test, the new approach, the new drug, the vaccine. This is we need also is the technology, for example, is for the AI. We're using the AI in Vietnam. It's for apply for chest X-ray reading for the people with the presumptive to be, and support is for the reading of the chest X-ray in the big six community, where I see the we have very limitation of the capacity of the health worker in the district level. So the technology like the AI is very important. The health system like the IT for the data recording and reporting is also is a very important, yeah, to measure the progress and to know is where we need to focus the resources to and also which is advocacy and health education. You need to be strengthened. Thank you.
Thanks a lot for sharing this overview. It is so important for us to hear that. And let us hope that with these efforts, Vietnam really moves towards NTB more at a more accelerated pace. As you know, at the UN high level meeting, all governments, heads, world leaders will be meeting on 22nd September. So what will be your call to the world leaders, if we can hear that? And anything else which you would like to add? Over to you, sir, before we wrap up. Thank you.
I think this is in the UN's high-level meeting. I think for this, this is a win coming in the few days more. I would like to see that the world leader can transfer the political momentum and attention from COVID-19 towards the TB. I would like to see the world leader regard TB as the original and universe pandemic, so that the additional resources being mobilized for pandemic prevention, preparedness, and response will be allocated to TB. I would like to see the world leader from the high-income country pledge to avail the resources needed to eliminate this detectable, curable, and preventable disease. And I want to see the world leader from the high-burden country pledge to optimize the utilization of their resources through the effective development and convincing the domestic co-financing with a long-term sustainable plan. And more above, I would like to see the world leader commit and be held accountable to ending TB within our lifetime. And in order to do that, beside the many key thing example for finding the undetected TB cases and treatment for all the TB cases in the community, also successful development and deploy a safe of the effective TB vaccine, and the continuous introduction of the other new pharmacologic and clinical intervention, such as the additional vaccine, safer drug, and shorter, more tolerant treatment regimen. And then it's to be coupled with the continued implementation and expansion of our key chain in the active case finding and the public-private mix, while we improve our key gap for the TB infection. And beyond their technical consideration, we need an overall change of the TB paradigm, the way it is regarded by the government and domestic stakeholder, multilateral and bilateral partner, and by all people in Vietnamese society in general. COVID-19 has been so that we are as a country can achieve when you have a clear directive, coordinated action, and unified communication across all levels of the government and the health system. Thus, it's critical that we find a way to change the mindset about TB, just like we change it about COVID-19, turning it into a matter of national health security and vital threat to our long-term economic development at the policymaker level, while eliminate the stigma and discrimination at the community level. And we also need to strengthen, define, and expand the domestic financing mechanism for TB. And in Vietnam, we are currently in the process of transitioning TB financing to our social health insurance scheme. The process is challenging and requires more coordinated effort across all levels of the government. However, it's critical to complete this transition quickly, effectively, and in patient-friendly fashion. Only in doing so can we sustain the high level of TB care currently provided by the NTP, while continuing to mobilize and allocate the external resources towards the intensified intervention aimed to at the accelerating program toward ending TB. We need to retain our trust for knowledge and design for the innovation. This includes upholding our position as the pathfinder country by creating an innovating environment for research and development, as well as the rapid rollout of the locally appropriate and validated tool and approach. So lastly, I think this is we need to expand our perception away from TB at a clinical initial and toward TB at a social disease. This includes dedicating resources towards the elimination of the catastrophic cost, including through the development provision and link it to the new and existing social protection mechanism. This is also include a greater focus on the psychosocial aspect of TB, how support can be provided beyond the pharmacological treatment, and how quick, how qualified apply can be fully restored following of the epidose of TB.
I agree, and thanks a lot for mentioning that TB is a social disease. So important. Everything which you have said, let us hope that it comes true with our prayers and wishes. Dr. Hua, we're very, very grateful that you spent so much of your busy of time, despite your busy schedule. And really inspiring for me to hear that the only evidence which has come from the world in the recent past that we can actually reduce the incidence so drastically is from Vietnam. In the back 40, 50 years, there's a lot of evidence. But the recent past is Vietnam, which shows the light to the world that it can be done if we reach out to everyone. So thanks a lot, Dr. Hua. Unless you want to say something else, we can wrap up.
Yeah, thank you, Ramat. Yeah, this is everything. This is I would like to say thank you. Yeah.
Thank you so much, Dr. Hua. And just for those who have joined us late, we were speaking to Dr. Nguyen Binh Hua. He's the Vice Director of Vietnam National Lung Hospital, Vice Manager of Vietnam's National TB Program, Director of Vietnam Integrated Center for TB and Respiratory Research, which is also known as VICTRY, and Vice Director of Vietnam Global Fund TB Project in Vietnam. So thanks a lot, sir. Salutes to you, and let us hope that Vietnam continues to inspire under your leadership. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. All the best.
Bye-bye.